Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Dear sisters and brothers in Christ, today let us pray together by singing a song.
There's nothing worth more that will ever come close. Nothing can compare your living hope. Your presence, Lord. I've tasted and seen of the sweetest of loves, where my heart becomes free and my shame is undone. Your presence, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the atmosphere. Your glory,
Blessed Virgin Mary, please intercede for us all. Hail Mary, full of grace.
The Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Today, we are going to think about the book of Daniel, chapter 10, verse 12.
He said to me, "Do not fear, Daniel, for from the first day that you set your mind to gain understanding and to humble yourself before your God, your words have been heard. And I have come because of your words."
See, an angel of the Lord, the archangel came to Daniel, and the angel was revealing a very, very important spiritual truth to beloved Daniel. Archangel revealed that when you make yourself humble before your God, your prayers were heard. Many times Daniel prayed in different ways, but this prayer was very powerful. So an angel was sent by God. So how did Daniel pray? Book of Daniel, chapter 10, verse 1 to 5.
In the third year of King Cyrus of Persia, a word was revealed to Daniel. who was named Belshazzar. The word was true, and it concerned a great conflict. He understood the word, having received understanding in the vision.
Yes, Daniel got a certain kind of vision, and he didn't. So he began to pray. The next words say, how did he prayed?
At that time, I, Daniel, had been mourning for 3 weeks. I had eaten no rich food, no meat or wine had entered my mouth, and I had not anointed myself at all for the full 3 weeks. On the 24th day of the first month, as I was standing on the bank of the great river, I looked up and saw a man clothed in linen with a belt of gold from Euphrates around his waist.
Yes, Daniel abandoned all delicious food. Daniel abandoned all kinds of perfumes. He observed days of lamentation for 3 weeks. That kind of prayer has much power. I remember one incident when I was doing a retreat at Limerick in Ireland. There came a family. Her husband was alcoholic for years. She has a great desire to go to the church together with his husband, but never it happened. He don't have faith in God. He never used to participate in family prayers. So whatever advice were given, nothing, he took nothing, no advice. So no peace in the house. That lady told me, hearing this passage, she took a decision. From then onwards, she abandoned all kind of meat. She didn't eat fish, no milk, no sugar, all delicious food. She abandoned all delicious food. Also, she began to serve her husband more and more with the humility and with the deep love. She began to serve her husband, no accusation. And also, she began to get up early in the morning by 4 o'clock. For 6 months, she did like this. In between, her husband used to inquire, why did you do all these things? You are getting weak. So no need of such kind of prayers. No. You have to eat. You have to be very well. Then this lady didn't reveal anything to her husband. She said, okay, no problem. She said, okay, no problem. No problem. I shall manage like that. After 6 months, her husband began to think like this. Why should I waste my life in such a way? Why should I drink? They participated in a retreat, and in that retreat, he got changed. Now, that lady told me, now we are experiencing a heavenly experience in our family life, because husband and her family atmosphere, everything, just divine experience there in the family. When this lady humbled herself and prayed, that prayer was very powerful, and that prayer brought result. An angel was sent to that family, and that angel make everything in order. My dear sisters and brothers, today we are thinking, humble yourself and the Lord will make you great. Another example, let us see from the book of Samuel, 2 Samuel chapter 7 verse 18.
Then King David went in and sat before the Lord and said, who am I, O Lord God?
Yes, he humbled himself and said, Lord, Lord, who am I and my household? Who am I? O Lord, continue.
what is my house that you have brought me this far?
Oh, that was the heart of King David. He was praying like this. You are doing great favors to me. I am not deserving all these things. I am too silly. I am worthless. You know me, what I am. I am very silly. I am negligible. I am unworthy. But you are doing much great things. You are doing great things to me and to my family. So David humbled himself before his God and prayed, and that prayer brought great result. And in the Bible we read, Heavenly Father, the Lord of hosts gave victory wherever David went. Hallelujah.
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 Let us examine another example. This prayer is prayer of Solomon. How did Solomon pray before his God? 1 Kings chapter 3 verses 4 to 7. Yes.
The king went to Gibeon to sacrifice there, for that was the principal high place. Solomon used to offer 1,000 burnt offerings on that altar. At Gibeon, the Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream by night, and God said, "Ask what I should give you."
Then, what was the response?
And Solomon said, "You have shown great and steadfast love to your servant, my father David, because he walked before you in faithfulness, in righteousness, and in uprightness of heart toward you. And you have kept for him this great and steadfast love, and have given him a son to sit on his throne today. And now, O Lord my God, you have made your servant king."
Yes.
"In place of my father David."
Yes.
"Although I am only a little child."
Yes.
"I do not know how to go out or come in."
Yes, Solomon was praying like a little child. He was praying, "And now, O Lord my God, you made your servant king in a great position, and although I am a little child, I do not know how to go out or how to come in. That much little I am, but you made me great." And he asked for wisdom, and Lord gave him great wisdom, wealth. He rewarded him. He blessed him with great blessings. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
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 I remember another example. One family came to me and said, "His only son, after his studies, he went abroad for his job. I think he was there in Saudi Arabia, I think. But somehow he was trapped there, and a relative of the king of Saudi Arabia put him in trouble, and his passport and everything was taken away, and he was trapped there. He can't come out. He complained to the Indian embassy, but no result. He complained wherever he can, but no result. But the hostility increased. He told everything to his father. He was in India. And his father in India approached the office of Indian Prime Minister, and he complained. He sent petitions and applications and complaints to External Affairs, to the office of the External Affairs Minister, and so on. Whatever they did, but no result. He approached Chief Minister also, but no result. No response. Then, when he was attending a retreat, he heard this passage: "Pray before the Lord with an humble heart. Lord will send an angel to you." Then he prayed, "Lord, I am helpless. Nobody is there to help me. My son is there. There also he is alone. So within 3 weeks. The Easter is coming within 3 weeks. So I tell you, you can do a miracle for me. And until then, I will not eat. If my son is not with me for this Easter, I will not eat, I will not drink, or I will not drink and eat on the day of Easter. He laid down on the floor and prayed and cried. And that prayer brought result. Within 2 weeks, miraculously, Lord intervened, and his son was released from the group, and he came to India, and both the father and the son, both of them came to Sekhiwan Retreat Center, where I am doing the ministry, and they gave this testimony before thousands and thousands of people. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
So they abandoned even food, even drink, everything they abandoned. They laid down on the floor and prayed, if my son is not here, I will not eat and drink. And they prayed and cried, laying on the ground. Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 18, verses 13 and 14.
But the tax collector, standing far off, would not even look up to heaven, but was beating his breast and saying, God, be merciful to me, a sinner. I tell you, this man went down to his home justified rather than the other. For all who exalt themselves will be humbled, but all who humble themselves will be exalted.
Yes, dear sisters and brothers, when you pray, when you come before your Lord, make humble yourself, and the Lord will make you great. Now let us pray. Hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, You are higher than any other. I got a feeler, awesome in power of God. Our God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the glory, Lord Jesus. Bless the name, Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Everyone who humbles himself will be exalted. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Sacramento, venerim ceruni, et anticum documento, novo cedere tui. Praeste fide supplemento, sansum defectui. Genitori genitorque laus jubilatio salus honoribus corque sita benedictio ostentia butroque composit laudatio. Amen.
Now let us accept Jesus as our Redeemer. When we accept Jesus in our heart as Redeemer, there is the mighty intervention of God. There will be. So as far as possible, as you can, call the name Jesus and accept him as as redeemer of our personal life. Jesus, you took away all our sins and you died on cross for me, and by your death I am redeemed. I believe that. I accept you as my savior. Hallelujah.
Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name. Jesus, Lamb of God, worthy is your name.
Blessed be his holy name. Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Blessed be his most sacred heart. Blessed be his most precious blood. Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, virgin and mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse. Blessed be God and his angels and in his saints.